Hello, everybody. We're in the middle of an Aeon Gauntlet with Belgamine, or Belgamina. Quite a name to live. So, it's time to fight Anima, or her version of Anima. But we have the Magic Sisters, so we're going to be okay. I hope. I mean, we can use every Aeon we have, which is all of them. So, it's not much of an issue. I mean, I suppose you could have skipped Yojimbo and the Magic Sisters at this point. But you would still have all five of your regular Aeons to fight this one. But we need to show the Magic Sisters anyway. And then we're going to one-shot them with Anima's Overdrive for the next battle. Choose your Aeon well, summoner. This is a broken summon, by the way. Their power is offset by the difficulty in controlling them. Because you can only give them vague commands. You can't select abilities that they have. But there are three of them, and they fight as three. They fight as a team of characters. So, do as you will. Fight. Fight. With almost 20,000 damage. Look at that! It's ridiculous! It's ridiculous what is going on here! And now we can just make them duplicate what they did. It's just that quick. How ridiculous is that? They're broken! It's absolutely a broken system. But what are you gonna do, really?
Take this.
So 60 stamina springs. And this will be the last one.
I will be the judge of your Aeon strength.
So now we have to fight her version of the Magic Sisters.
Now, are you
but
ready?
Anima's in overdrive. So it's not gonna matter. Her version of these Aeons are pretty watered down considering how far into the game you have to be to actually get them and fight her. You know, clearly you can't, like, until you've completed the entire pilgrimage, you can't get Baj Temple Aeons. So you could or the Magic Sisters. So they should be stronger, because your characters have to be strong enough to beat Lady Unalesca.
Choose your Aeon well, son.
All right, and then you'll see how broken this is as well. This is the best, because this overdrive, I mean, clearly will just affect all three of them. I'm sure all of them would, like, any overdrive would affect anything on screen, but I don't know that for a fact. Seems like it would. Yeah, we will see the Magus' Sisters overdrive at some point in the game, because you can grand summon them. And it's interesting. I don't know what to say about, aside from that. All right, this should one-shot them. It really should. Oh, well, we froze for a minute there. I have to stop playing. I've been doing a marathon play session. This is the last thing we're going to do. So this video will be a partial where I pick up afterwards. This is nice, too, because it doesn't give them a chance to do things like auto-life or anything like that. It just destroys them. It just mathematically destroys them. Overkills every single one of them. So, that's the end of Belgamine. She has no more Aeons to challenge us with.
Stop. That is enough.
Because there are no more Aeons in the game.
Ah, you have made some progress. And for that, I am glad. Take this. It may come in handy.
Thank you. Perhaps you'll teach me again someday?
That's not possible. You have already surpassed your father. There is nothing more I can teach you. My work here on Spira is done. Time for me to go.
Send her.
She's very... yeah. We can do that.
Yes.
Is in your hands. Destroy Sin and save Spira.
I would have pushed Do Nothing, but she's so nice, she deserved that. So we get the Moon Seagull, which is actually, it's the other half of Yuna's, it's the third part of Yuna's ultimate weapon. So we have the Moon Crest. We got it at on a beach in Besaid at the very beginning of the game, and we couldn't possibly use it, but we knew we would need it. And we got that one there, so now we could actually go to Makalania Woods, which we're going to do. Oh. Wait a minute, I actually do want to save. Because I didn't like that freeze moment. Alright, so this should be reasonably easy, and I'll show you what happens to these weapons as we make them, which will be nice. I don't have any of my taming weapons on, and that kind of stinks because I'm going to hit one battle on the way out of here, I always do. Told ya. So we'll be capturing these things, but that's not an issue because we already have them anyway. All right. So, what we're gonna have to do after this is, we could probably do a little bit of plotline. There's not a lot of plotline left, to tell you the honest truth. But so we go up here, and we have to go back to that place where we charged up the Celestial Mirror. And, like I said, I'll show you step by step exactly what happens. With each weapon. So, we come up here. Now, Yuna has... I'm going to equip it. So we just go equip, and she has... This is her... No AP is her weapon. But if we go up here, it'll ask us... Have you the Celestial Weapons? And then who will present their weapon? Yuna. And then you must offer the Moon Crest. Complete the ritual. Yes. Now what it'll do is everything we offer will fill in two of the item spots on the weapon. So we'll have a partial ultimate weapon right now. And I'll show you. See, so now it's no AP, but with double overdrive. So, we go back up. Have you the Celestial Weapons. Yuna. And the Moon Seagull, yes. And that completes it. The weapon obtained its maximum power. This is the best weapon for her in the game. And I will... No. We do have other weapons, but... So there you go. Break damage limit. Triple overdrive. Double AP. 1 MP cost for everything. So if we go to use abilities for Yuna... Oh no, outside of battle it doesn't work. But in battle, everything costs 1 AP. Or 1 magic point. It's ridiculous. So... yes, there's one for every character, some of them harder to get than others. So what we're going to do is I'm going to stop the video here, and when we come back, we got a lot of backtrack to do. So I'll see you guys for that, and you know, see you for the second half of the video. Hello, everybody. It's time to board the airship again. We have things to do. A lot of it is capturing monsters, but we'll deal with that. Okay, so for the first time, we actually can go back to be safe.
Here we go.
I don't know exactly where we land, but okay, on the beach by the SS Kilika or whatever. So we gotta go this way to get to the village. And, we gotta go back to catching weapons if we wanna catch stuff. Clearly. Alright. So, we'll see what we hit on the way through here. There are only 4 enemies. So there's a flan for Lulu, and then there's an enemy for Titus and Waka, and well, there's 2 of them. So the dingo,
it's over.
And the water flan. We don't have a lot of options. We have to kind of walk around here, so. Okay, that bird is number 3 for us.
Take that.
So the condor. Maybe there are only 3. I don't remember. Doesn't seem right that there would be only 3.
Take that.
But okay. And of course the AP and stuff doesn't matter. It's so low. These enemies didn't level up or anything while we were gone. So these are areas that have save points where we warped, so we've been there. Oh, okay, so here, Kilika and Beaconel joined as 1. So there's a clue on Kilika and a clue on Beaconel that we combined together, and I believe they spell victorious. I believe it's just the letters mixed up and you have to combine them, but could be wrong.
Take that.
All right. Quickest random battles ever. I haven't returned back here in my practice file, so there may be a cutscene. But certainly what I'm interested in is over here.
Advance toward the shore, killing every fiend you see, and don't let your guard down when you get there. Report immediately if Sin appears. Crusaders, move out!
Sir!
Hey!
Hello?
What do you mean, low? What's going on?
What, this? Just training.
Ah.
You never know when Sin will come. We have to keep sharp for the village's sake.
But really, my heart's heavy. It's not like I can go around crying in front of my men.
Luzu was probably the same way. No matter what happened, he'd never let it show in front of you. Always a fighter. Never complain. You know?
Maybe you're right. I'd better be going. My men await.
Good luck.
You too.
Okay. Clearly, there's an alternate cutscene here if the other person survives. However, to get to that cutscene, I'm going to have to play all the way from Jose Temple all the way back through the pilgrimage. I'm not saying I'm not going to do that. You're just not going to see it right now. It'll probably come way towards the end of this LP. What? No comment on the cat? Okay, well, anyway. The reason we actually came back into town, aside from that, is that there actually should be, I believe. There is. There's a sphere here.
Smallest heap of huts I ever seen.
Now, that looks like a fine place to live. Auron.
My lord.
When this is over, could you bring Yuna here? I want her to lead a life far away from this conflict.
You have my word. I will bring her here.
Thank you, Auron. You're a good friend.
What are you guys doing? Let's go! I'm so hungry I could eat a shoe puff whole.
Sorry. Well, let's go then.
Alright. Now, there are multiple. To get Auron's last overdrive, we have to collect all the spheres. So, we will be getting those as we're traveling around doing this whole capture thing. So, next we're going to go to Killica, but I'm going to walk there. I'm actually going to walk to the boat and take the boat. Because I think there may be a sphere on board. I'm not sure about that, but it's worth a try. Ugh, I was looking at my walkthrough and I got caught. Oh, the SS Leaky is where it is. So. I'll take more water flans. I mean, I don't really care. We'll capture everything we can get here. We have to go to Killica anyway, because... Well, because. Because that's the way to go. Clearly. There are certain places we can't go. If you try to go to Jose Temple, they will push you out. our rebel status is such a problem. Alright. Long walk. 3 random battles, probably. Let's see if my prediction is right. Well, not at this rate it won't be. So there's one. Yeah, I think there's just 3.
Take that.
whatever. I mean, we're gonna have to come back to get all 10. Or 10 of each, so. Alright, look, we might get away with just 2. Oh no, ambushed.
It's over.
Alright. Also, one of the pieces of Orin's ultimate weapon are accomplished by catching monsters. I think it's the only reward for catching monsters that involves an ultimate weapon aside from getting Yuna's ultimate weapon that way. Okay, wrong way. That's where we got on shore, so we need to go south here. All right, so when we come back, the voyage to Killica. Bye, everybody.